Good afternoon, my dear colleagues. Let's start our lecture. Theme of today's lecture is onco-urology. It is a very actual theme. You know that general oncology takes the second part in death after cardiovascular diseases. And independently on your future specialties, you will meet this category of patients. You know that the main problem of general oncology is delay diagnostics. What is the cause of this situation? First of all, very often, clinical manifestation of oncological disease appears only in advanced stages of the disease. Initial stages, they don't have any clinical manifestations. On one hand, on the other hand, very often patients and sometimes even doctors don't pay necessary attention on initial symptoms of these diseases. They may be general these symptoms, you know, they are the same in all these oncological diseases, as well as local symptoms, and sometimes localization of these local symptoms is far from the main source of the tumor. And so I always tell the students, you must try to know initial clinical manifestations. First of all, let's discuss tumors of the kidney. Sorry, some protactinic carcinoma. Moment. Так, some problems, technical problems. Wait, please, one moment. Дима,
отключите первака ОБС. ОБС. Да. Давай.
И не листается.
Так и должно быть. Таким вот образом.
Теперь будет листаться. Да. Ага, спасибо. Так, sorry, some technical problems. And we will continue. Adenocarcinoma of the kidney. Now you can see from this table that in the United States in 2060, an estimated 31.8 hundred cases of adenocarcinoma of the kidney are expected to be diagnosed, and 11,600 deaths will occur from this disease. Renal cell carcinoma accounts for roughly 2.5% of adult cancers and constitutes approximately 85% of all primary malignant renal tumors. Renal cell carcinoma occurs most commonly in the fifth to sixth decade and has a male-female ratio of 2-to-1. The incidence of renal cancer may vary based on race, with black men demonstrating a higher incidence than in men of all other races. Black men may also have a higher likelihood of subsequent renal cell carcinoma in the contralateral kidney. Asians appear to have the lowest incidence of renal cell carcinoma. Multiple terms have been used to describe renal adenocarcinoma, including hypernephroma, Gravitz tumor, clear cell carcinoma, and alveolar carcinoma. The cause of renal cell carcinoma is unknown. Occupational exposures, chromosomal aberration, and tumor suppressor genes have been implicated. Most investigations demonstrate at least a two-fold increase in risk for the development of renal cell carcinoma in smokers. What classification of renal tumors? Well, first of all, we can divide it into malignant tumors and benign tumors. According to localization in kidney, maybe tumors of parenchymal tumors, and the pelvic tumor, which localized in the bilocalicial system. Unfortunately, more than 90% of renal tumors are malignant tumors, on the one hand. On the other hand, benign tumors have a tendency to malignization. Today it may be benign tumors, and in a few months it may be malignant tumors. And so every renal tumor might be estimated as malignant tumor. The possibility of mistake, unfortunately, is very low. Pot classification. You can see that renal parenchymal neoplasms may be divided into benign tumors and malignant tumors. I will not tell you detail about histological structure of benign tumors. You can see it on this slide. Malignant tumors, most often renal cell carcinoma, the adenocarcinoma, clear cell carcinoma is the same. Separate place has nephroblastoma or Wilms tumor. Wilms tumor number 4. It is this embryological tumor which divides because of disturbances of embryogenesis and manifests itself in the earlier years of life. And you must remember, if you meet a baby 3 to 4 years old with the abdominal tumor, first of all, you must exclude renal tumor, the Wilms tumor. Renal pelvic neoplasms also may be divided into benign tumors. You can see this histological structure. And malignant tumors, transitional cell carcinoma, the most often. By the way, the same histological structure will be in urethral tumors as well as in urinary blood tumors. What is the features of this renal pelvic neoplasms, malignant tumors? Because they spread downward along urine flow. Along urine flow, it spreads in urethra, it spreads into the urinary bladder. And so, in cases pelvic tumor, when we perform operative treatment, we must remove all these parts. We must perform operation nephrouretrectomy and even partial resection of the urinary bladder around orifice of the urethra, because secondary microscopical sources may be localized in these places, in urethra and urinary bladder. And if we leave urethra, maybe in few months, maybe development of this secondary tumors. Pathology renal carcinoma originates from the proximal renal tubular epithelium. This tumor occurs with the acquired frequency in either kidney and are randomly distributed in the upper and lower poles. Renal cell carcinoma originates in the cortex and tend to grow out into perinephric tissue, causing the characteristic bulge of mass effect that aids in the detection by diagnostic imaging studies. Renal cell carcinoma do not have true capsules, but may have pseudocapsules and compressed renal parenchyma, fibrous tissues, and inflammatory cells. I didn't tell you that unfortunately, till 30% of patients visit doctor first time when they already have distant metastasis. In this picture you can see tumor masses localized in the calyces. You can see that in this place, and parenchymal is not affected yet in this picture. In this picture you can see also pelvic tumor, but it has already growth outside of the pelvis in parenchyma. It is very characteristic picture of adenocarcinoma. You can see different colors of tissues. Yellow, it is fat. Gray, it is necrotic tissues, and reddish, hemorrhages. Such variant of renal tumor is possible. More than one half of kidney is affected by tumor. And in this picture you can see only lower pole, which is not involved in this process. Huge tumor. Why does it reach such huge sizes? What is the cause? Because localization of kidney is in retroperitoneal space. It is a large cavity space, and in the beginning stages, growth of this tumor occurs without any dysfunction of adjacent organs and without symptoms, and it is one of the causes why these tumors reach such huge sizes. A histological picture of tumors. In this case, you can see cysts and tumor, combination of cysts and tumors. Sometimes in this picture you can see pelvic tumor, pelvic tumor. Pathogenesis, renal cell carcinoma, a vascular tumor that tend to spread either by direct invasion through the renal capsule into perinephric fat and adjacent visceral structures, or by direct extension into the renal vein. Also, approximately 25 to 30 of patients have evidence of metastasis disease at presentation. By other words, when they visit a doctor first time. The most common site of distant metastasis is the lung. You know that theoretically any tumor can give metastasis in different tissues, in organism, any tissues, but they are the most often places of metastasis. And so lung is the most often. This picture you can see lungs, liver, bone, ipsilateral adjacent lymph nodes, adrenal glands, brain, opposite kidney. But why this knowledge are very important for us? Because sometimes manifestation of metastasis may be earlier than the main source of tumor. Now, for example, metastasis in lung can manifest itself by cough, hemoptysis, pneumonia, bronchitis, pleuritis, etc. In these cases, X-ray investigation performs and may be determined a tumor of lung, nodule of tumor, which can be estimated as primary tumor. Lobectomy performs separative treatment, and only that determines that it is not primary tumor, it is metastasis of a renal tumor. Or in other cases, what metastasis is in bones, what manifestation of this metastasis is possible? Pain in bones, pathological fractures of bones, which occurs without trauma, background of the absolutely normal condition. Well, you can see the metastasis, multiple metastasis in lungs, metastasis in femur bone, you can see this, femoralis, and destruction of bones, tissues. And now I'll show you some metastasis which can be very rare. It is unusual metastasis. This patient has metastasis in skull bone. You can see metastasis in skull bone. CT scanning of this patient, you can see destruction of the skull bones. No? Here, sorry, again some problems. Так, what can I do? Again, some technical problems. Wait, please, few minutes. Yes. Так, in this picture you can see this destruction of the skull bones. Next, this, the same patient, it is angiography, selective renal angiography. You can see large tumor, which takes half, one half of the kidney. Well, also this patient had nephrectomy a few months ago, and he has secondary metastasis in skull bones. This picture also. Next, CT scanning of this patient, you can see this destruction of the skull bones. This patient has metastasis in palate. He has renal tumor, but second metastasis in palate. Metastasis in sternum. Also, this patient has renal tumor and such metastasis. I demonstrated you unusual metastasis. Next, what classification of tumor? You know, general classification, TNM, TNM. What means TT? Tumor, да? TX, primary tumor, cannot be assessed. T0, no evidence of primary tumor. T1, tumor 7 centimeters or less, limited to kidney. Which divides into T1A, T1B. More interesting for us, tumor when it's less than 4 centimeters, limited to kidney. In these cases, we can perform organ preserving operation, partial nephrectomy, which can be performed by open operation or by endoscopical, laparoscopical operation. T2, tumor more than 7 centimeters, but limited to kidney. T3, tumor extends into major veins or invades adrenal glands or perinephric tissues, but not beyond Gerota's fascia. Gerota's fascia is fascia retroperitonealis, Latin term. T3 may be A, B, C. You can see in this slide different adjacent tissues which are affected by tumor. Adrenal glands, perirenal fat, renal sinus fat, B, renal vein or its segmental branches, or vena cava below diaphragm, etc. And T4, tumor invites beyond Gerota's fascia, growth outside of Gerota's fascia. Next, N. You can see NX regional lymph nodes cannot be assessed, and 0, no regional lymph nodes metastasis, and 1, metastasis in the single regional lymph nodes, and 2, when 2 or more regional lymph nodes are affected by metastasis. What means M? It is distant metastasis. X cannot be assessed, M0, no distant metastasis, M1, a distant metastasis presence. But sometimes correlation between T and M is absent. Tumor sometimes may be small, but already gives distant metastasis. And opposite, maybe large tumor without distant metastasis. This classification is used in the United States, tumor staging, Robson. Да? You can see also different variants, stage 1, 2, stage 3, A, B, C, and stage 4, A and B. 4A tumor involves adjacent organs other than the adrenal, colon, pancreas, etc. stage. For B, distant metastasis presence. And we can use different combination. TNM, maybe T1, N0, M0. Maybe T2, N1, M0, or different combination. And it allows us to characterize process. What process has our patient? Well, this picture demonstrates also these stages. Look, please. First stage, less than 1 centimeter. Second stage, more than 7 centimeters. Stage 3, when spreading of tumor along the renal vessels into the vena cava, but the rotas fascia is not affected. And in this stage, fourth stage, you can see that a growth spreads outside of the rotas fascia and lymph nodes are affected and distant metastasis presence. What clinical manifestation of renal tumor? It is very important question. The classically distributed trait of gross hematuria, flank pain, and palpable mass occurs in only 10 to 15% of patients and is frequently a manifestation of advanced disease. What means classical trait? Which presence in most often cases, no? And we cannot classify it as classical trait, no? Because very often patient has only one symptom or maybe two symptoms from this pain, hematuria, and palpable mass. Pain in abdominal abdominal masses or both are seen in approximately 40% of patients. Symptoms secondary to metastatic disease such as dyspnea, cough, headache, pain from lung, brain and bone metastasis lead to diagnostics in up to 30% of patients. What type of hematuria? Most often hematuria, total hematuria, which we can see from the beginning to the end of the void. Sometimes maybe blood clots. And if patient tells that he has vermiforms blood clots, we can think that they formed in the ureter, so bleeding from the upper urinary paths. And in these cases, we can suspect a renal tumor. It is very important symptoms. What are features of bleeding in renal tumor? Well, first of all, it may be painless on one hand. On the other hand, it may be short time, it may be 1 day, 2 days, and then it disappears suddenly. And it may be repeated only in a few months, in 4 months, in 5 months, when oncological process already progressed and we lost the time. Well, general manifestation. What are general manifestation? It may be loss of the weight, hypertension, and other. We have picture with other paraneoplastic syndromes in renal cell carcinoma, such as hypertension, 38%, anemia, fever, sometimes 70%. By the way, hypertension may be because of compression of intrarenal vessels and develops parenchymal nephrogenous hypertension. FIVA, which is 70%, abnormal liver function test findings, hypercalcemia, polycythemia, etc. Diagnostics of renal tumor. No, first of all, complaints and history. You can ask the patient detail about this clinical manifestation. Physical examination. And during physical examination, we can palpate enlarged kidney, the palpable masses. We can determine it, but sometimes we can. These tumors are impalpable. Why? First of all, it may be small tumor. It may be tumor of the upper pole. Maybe fatty patient, and we cannot palpate it successfully. Laboratory investigation. By physical examination, you can also palpate varicocele. What means varicocele? Varicocele is dilations of veins, varicose dilation of veins of the spermatic cord. Maybe two variants of varicocele. Varicocele may be idiopathic varicocele, which develops in the teenage, 13, 14, 15 years old. And most often it develops on the left side due to anatomical features. Pay attention. Left vena testicularis enter into vena renalis. Right vena testicularis enter into vena cava inferior. And conditions for outflow of blood better from the left side, from the left vein. In the left side was. And varicocele develops most often in the left side. And so if you meet the patient with the oncological danger, in oncological danger age, after 50 years old, which tell you that he has varicocele, which appeared, for example, a few months ago, and especially if it appeared on the right side, I said you that idiopathic varicocele develops in the teenage and on the left side. And so if we meet this patient, we can suspect a renal tumor and immediately perform necessary investigations such as ultrasonic investigation, CT scanning, etc. Well, other symptoms, laboratory investigation, ultrasonography is very important, ultrasonography, because it allows us to determine tumors 2 to 3 centimeters, or even from these sizes. And on the other hand, it allows to differentiate cysts and the tumor, because cysts, it is fluid-containing formations, and tumors have tissues and vascularization. Blood flow determines in this place. Так, intravenous urography, which is X-ray investigation. Renal angiography, it is also very informative investigation, but it is invasive investigation. Radionuclide imaging, CT scanning, MRI, instrumental, and cytological examination. But don't confuse cytological examination and biopsy. Cytological investigation of urine allows us to determine atypical cells, which can be caused by other diseases, not only by tumor. Biopsy, it is the more informative investigation for the diagnostics. Now I'll show you some picture of ultrasonic. You can see tumor of the kidney, large tumor. In this case also you can see kidney, and tumor, enough large tumor. This gray scale allows to determine the tumor. Special investigation with the contrast substance allows to determine vessels. Renal cell carcinoma, you can look at these three variants. Also grayscale ultrasound, hypoechogenic mass in lower pole. Next, color Doppler. You know that Dopplerography allows to determine blood flow in the tissues. That allows us to determine vascularity, you can see it, and pulse the Doppler allows to determine blood flow arterial wave. The same here also, we determine the gray scale, Leber-Yeast, that is special contrast substance, allows us to determine blood flow, and selective renal arteriography allows to determine tumor. Excretory urography, you can see normal picture of the right kidney. Left kidney, pay attention, deformation of the bilocalicial system by large tumor. Next, in this case, you also can see deformation of bilocalicial system by tumor. But in this case, we cannot be sure that it is tumor because the same changes may be caused by renal cysts. Tumor of the left kidney, amputation of upper calyces, and you can see deformation of the bilocalicial system. Also, deformation of bilocalicial system and deviation of ureter in the spine, because large tumor deviates this ureter. Multiple filling defects in the ureter caused by ureteral tumor. Also, absolutely normal picture of excretory urography, but angiography allows to determine tumor which localized superficial and doesn't deform bilocalicial system. Deviation of vena cava, it is vena cava graphia, by tumor of the right kidney. You can see angiographical symptoms, pathological vessels in tumor. The compare place normal vessels, and pathological vessels in tumor. Also, upper pole is affected by tumor. Renal arteriography. Such picture caused by renal tumor. You can see ultrasonic picture of the tumor, the same patient, you can see. CT scanning, huge tumor of the left kidney, compare right kidney and left kidney. The same patient, you can see aortography, you can see huge tumor of the kidney. CT scanning is very informative, you can see right kidney, liver, and left kidney, the tumor of left kidney. Wilms tumor, I said you that Wilms tumor may be most often in the initial years of life, in children, 3, 4, 5 years old, you can see huge tumor of the right kidney, the same right kidney. Sometimes a renal tumor may be determined incidentally. Perform some investigation and you can see this tumor may be a detriment. In this case, it is 2 to 3 centimeters, small tumors, that you can see, right side, also small tumor, 2 to 3 centimeters in this case. Operative treatment may be performed the most effectively, and sometimes even laparoscopical partial nephrectomy may be performed, and the most effective treatment may be only in these initial stages. Also, picture of renal tumor, you can see the upper pole. Treatment of renal tumors. You know, 30 years ago, most often, 30 to 40 years ago, nephrectomy, the radical nephrectomy was performed. But last year, in cases of small tumor, approximately till 4 centimeters may be performed, organ preserving nephrectomy, and even by laparoscopic technologies, radical nephrectomy, partial nephrectomy, tumor less than 4 centimeters, nephro or ureteractomy in cases of pelvic tumor. As you remember, I said you that spreading of pelvic tumors downward, and so we must remove all possible sources of this tumor. Endoscopical surgery, radiation therapy, immunotherapy. No, radiation therapy is not effective because it may be performed only in cases after nephrectomy when surgeon is not sure that he removed all lymph nodes, for example. Last time, targeted therapy is used very often. This, what means target? Vascular endothelium growth factor. When we use special drugs, which influence only in targets, special targets in the tumor, and they decrease growth factor of vascular endothelium. So, development of these vessels decreased. It is not radical therapy because we only decrease growth of this tumor. You can see drugs, Sutent, Dexavar, Avastin, which we use for this purpose. Так, ну, when local spreading of the tumor, we can perform partial nephrectomy. You can see this picture. In this picture, you can see phases of this stages of this operation, separation of the tumor. Gradually, it separated by instruments, by finger. Next, it removes this tumor, the leg of the tumor. Then, coagulation of surface of this tumor by laser and stitches of the capsule of the kidney. Removed kidney with the tumor, you can see during operation. And now pay attention, please. This table is very important. Survival rate after renal adenocarcinoma treatment. So this patient was operated in different stages. And what is survival rate after these operations? In stage T1, about 80% of patient lives till 5 years, and more than 70 lives till 10 years. Very good results in tumors. T2, what means T2? When more than 7 centimeters, the sizes of tumor, or N plus when lymph nodes already is affected. Only 40% of this patient live till 5 years, and only 24 till 10 years. And next, M plus, it means that patient has distant metastasis. So, and even if we performed operative treatment when we remove renal tumor, only 8% of these patients live till 5 years, and nobody till 10 years. And now recall, please, on the beginning of our lecture, I told you then till 25 to 30% of patients visit a doctor first time in cases when they have already distant metastasis, every third patient. So the main task is early diagnostic. If we can diagnose it in the initial stages, we can treat this patient successfully. And so please try to study, you must study initial symptoms, you must know initial symptoms of metastasis, of these tumors. In this cases, you can save the patient when you will perform necessary investigation and refer the patient to specialists in time. Next, bladder carcinoma, urinary bladders, incidence. The bladder cancer is the second most common cancer of the genitourinary tract, and it accounts for 7% of new cancer cases in men and 2% of new cancer cases in women. There is a positive social class gradient for bladder cancer in both sexes. The average age at diagnosis is 65 years. At that time, approximately 45% of bladder cancer are localized to the bladder. 15% have spread to regional lymph nodes or distant sites. Risk factors. Smoking, you can see the influence on the incidence of this disease. Occupational exposure accounts for 15 to 35% of cases in men and 1 to 6% in women. Because in the chemical rubber, petroleum, and other specialties. Histopathology. 98% of all bladder cancer are epithelium malignancies, with the most being the transitional cell carcinoma. You can see the transitional cell carcinoma about 90% transitional cell carcinoma. Other histological structure, more earlier. Picture of removed, that is huge tumor. Stages of this disease. Stage zero, when mucus, urothelium initial affected. Stage one, when mucus and submucus layer is affected. Stage two, growth spreads the half of muscular wall, but doesn't half, only half the muscular wall. Stage three, whole wall of the urinary bladder, the muscular wall, but it doesn't spread outside of peritoneum, And fourth stage, it spread outside of the urinary bladder. This picture also demonstrates different variants of spreading of tumor. Initial stages, these tumors, first stage, second stage, third stage, and fourth stage. In this case, tumor spreads in the vesica seminalis or in prostate. Well, signs and symptoms. The main symptom also is rose painless hematuria, 80%. Dysuria and irritative symptoms till 20%. What is urea? Different manifestations of urea. Maybe ruptured void in when tumor localized in the neck of the urinary bladder. Secondary urinary infection till 30%, and upper urinary tract obstruction. Initial stages very rare, advanced disease 50%. What means upper urinary tract obstruction? When compression of the ureter, orifice of the ureter, or a distal part of the ureter by this tumor, urine flow distorts and develops dilation of the ureter and pyelo calicial symptoms. And development of ureterohydronephrosis, pyelonephritis, etc. Symptoms of metastasis till 10% is not very often. No? Symptoms of metastasis. Diagnosis. Signs and symptoms. The main symptom I said you, hematuria. The what variants of hematuria? Maybe total or final hematuria. Total, understandable. What means final hematuria? When only at the end of the void blood appears in urine, when neck of the urinary bladder is affected. Physical examination doesn't allow us most often to determine tumor because palpation of urinary bladder tumor is very difficult. Urinary cytology, cystoscopy and biopsy is very important investigation when we perform investigation by cystoscope, the optical instrument, allows us to see very clear localization and the shape of this tumor, relation to orifices of the ureter, and in this case we perform biopsy. The pelvic ultrasonography also very informative investigation and allows us to determine tumors 2 centimeters and more. X-ray examination, CT scan and MRI, and if it's necessary, chest X-ray, radionuclide, bone scan. In this picture you can see tumor of the urinary bladder and mucosa of the urinary bladder, which can be visible through this flexible cystoscope. Different variants of tumor, you can see different pictures. In our days we perform so-called cystoscopy with the special, special color. Fluorescence is the scape. We introduced 5-aminolevulin acid. And after some time, we performed cystoscopy. Compare, please. In this picture, you can see the same patient, normal mucus. But after this fluorescent cystoscopy, we can see that these parts of the mucus is already affected. It is usual cystoscopy. In this case, also. Usual cystoscopy and fluorescent cystoscopy. You can see places which are affected by tumor process. Also, examples of this fluorescent cystoscopy. Well, excretory urography. We can see very clear pilocalycial system, left, right, and we can see ureters, which are not dilated, and fill in the fact of the urinary bladder. You can see that growth of this tumor doesn't spread into ureter because dilation of ureter is absent. Also, fill in the fact, this arrow shows you fill in the fact of endocystoscopy. Huge filling defect. Also, filling defect of the urinary bladder. The same. No? The similar filling defect may cause stone of the urinary bladder, non-opaque stone. But in these cases, you can see not clear borders of the urinary bladder. Так, and possible complication. There may be when tumor localized near orifice of the ureter, maybe a development of ureterohydronephrosis. Так, CT scan in urinary bladder tumor, you can see it. MRI, on an MRI also we can see clear this tumor. Treatment, non-operative treatment is the most radical treatment. Maybe transureteral resection by special cystoscope, resectoscope. Partial cystectomy, maybe performed, or radical cystectomy. The main problem is derivation of urine in cases of radical cystectomy. Different methodics of operative treatment with formation of artificial urinary bladder from bowel, the most often. And you understand that it is very difficult operations and normal physiological avoiding is impossible most often in these cases. Intravesical hemotherapy, you can see intravesical, maybe introduction of different drugs, mitomycin, doxorubicin, tiotefa, BCG in the urinary bladder, and these substances influence on the tumor. Radiotherapy and chemotherapy, maybe cisplatin, intravenous, and combination of these variants of treatment. Maybe adjuvant therapy, maybe neoadjuvant therapy. What means adjuvant therapy? When chemotherapy or radiotherapy performs after operative treatment. What means neoadjuvant? Sometimes before operative treatment it performs, for example, radiotherapy to decrease sizes and spreading of tumor and then performs operative treatment. In this picture you can see cystoscope, resectoscope. At the end of this instrument, special loop presence. Electric current goes through this loop, enlarged picture, through this loop. And this equipment allows to move this loop in this direction. And when we apply this loop to tissues and perform this movement, we perform electroresection layer by layer, as you can see in this picture, also this variant. But you can see loop behind tumor and this surface after resection, when we move this loop and perform electroresection of tissues. Well, next prostatic tumors. Prostatic tumor. The most often is BPH. BPH. What means BPH? It is benign tumor. BPH is the most common benign tumor in men, and its incidence in age related. The prevalence of histologic BPH in autopsy studies rises from approximately 20% in men age 40 to 50 to 50% in men age 50 to 60 and over 90% in men older than 80 years old. Statistics shows that 60 years old males, half of them already have BPH. But only half of these 50% have a clinical manifestation. And so you understand that rise of incidence occurs in the older males, and in 70 years old, more than 50% already have BPH. Well, sorry, risk factors. No, we cannot tell what is the cause of this disease, because doesn't depend on profession and some other things. Some hereditary factors influence on this disease. By other ways, genetic predisposition presence. And approximately 50% of men under the age of 16 who undergo surgery for BPH may have a heritable form of this disease. Patients with the active sexual life and as well as monk suffered from this disease. It doesn't depend on sexual activity and other things. Unfortunately, it's unknown, this etiology of this disease. I want to demonstrate you anatomical features of the BPH. It localized lower than urinary bladder and urethra perforates prostate. And so any enlargement of prostate leads to compression of the urethra and subsequent disturbances of urine flow, because diameter of urethra decrease and urine flow stops. Next, pay attention please of relation of prostate gland and rectum. And we can perform physical examination of prostate gland only by digital rectal examination. We perform it through rectum, the palpate prostate, and only by this way we can estimate it. What happens during PPH? After 50 years old, when different imbalance of hormonal phone develops and parauretral glands gives growth of this tissue, parauretral glands here. Well, you can see a picture, it is anterior picture and lateral picture. What happens? Pay attention please on this picture, it is enough to demonstrate. These tissues starts growing, the initial stage, earlier stage of BPH, and initial compression of the urethra. Tissue of prostate gland is not change. Next, moderate. You can see that compression increase because tumor also enlarge and compress this part of the urethra. And in this case, advanced stage of BPH, you can see that thin urethra, large tumor, and pay attention, what happens with the tissue of prostate gland? It atrophy of this tissue develops, because you compare volume of prostate gland here and here on this picture. And gradually develops this compression. First stages. Initial, we can divide three stages. The first stage of compensation, second of subcompensation, and stage of decompensation. What means compensation? For example, in this variant, detrusor muscle of the urinary bladder can evacuate all urine from the urinary bladder. Some problems present because compression of urethra already occurs, but detrusor evacuate all urine. Next, gradually, maybe during 1 year, maybe during 2-3 years, function of prostate gland, function of detrusor decreased gradually. And it already cannot evacuate all urine from the urinary bladder, and some quantity of urine remains after voiding phase of subcompensation. Gradually, this stage progresses, and quantity of residual urine, what means residual urine? More than 50%, 50 ml after voiding. Gradually, it arrives, and maybe 100, 200, 300, 400, and in advanced stage, maybe next situation. Atonia of detrusor gradually develops. Atonia of detrusor. Urinary bladder may be over-distended, 400 to 500 ml in the urine, and also paresis of sphincter, and urine drop by drop excretes from urethra. We call it ischuria paradoxa. On one hand, it is ischuria, patient cannot void, but paradox that urine drop by drop excretes through urethra. A stage of decompensation most often accompanied with pyelonephritis, chronic renal insufficiency, and other complications of the prostate gland, and all patients might be treated in the first or second stage. Third stage, it is decompensation. All organs and systems are suffered from in this situation. I repeat, patients might be treated in the first or second stage. Look, please, this picture. Initial compression, you can see initial compression of the urethra and what happens in advanced stages. But pay attention. Sometimes sizes of benign prostate hyperplasia doesn't influence on the obstruction of urethra. Maybe large tumor, but infravesical obstruction is small. On the other hand, maybe small tumor, but compression is very marked. In other words, correlation between sizes and stage and severity of dysuria is absent. Compare, please, in this picture you can see normal outflow. In this case, you can see obstruction. Not also in this picture, the same picture of urethroscopy. Lobes of prostate gland, tuberculum seminalis, you can see that normal picture. What happens? You can see obstruction, compression of urethra, but by BPH. Different complication, development of the diverticles, stones of the urinary bladder, urethra, hydronephrosis, inflammatory process, etc. Such variants of complications. Next, symptoms of BPH. We can divide it into obstructive and irritative. What means obstructive? Decreased force and caliber of stream. Especially for students, I tell that maybe symptom of wet shoes. What means symptom? In normal urine excretes from urethra as parabola, urine stream. But when then obstruction, infravesical obstruction presence, urine excretes from the urethra and falls down on the shoes. No, it is not scientific. It is only for your memory. Symptom of wet shoes. Sensation of incomplete bladder emptying. When patient feels that some quantity of urine remains in the urinary bladder, double voiding, after voiding in 5 to 10 seconds, maybe excretion of 20 to 30 ml of urine, a straining to urinate, understandable. The patient try to help by muscles of abdominal wall to evacuate urine, increase time of voiding, understandable. If urine stream has small caliber, more time is necessary for emptying of the urinary bladder. Irritative symptoms. Irritative symptoms are the most unpleasant for patient. What means urgency? In normal, we can regulate urge to void, and they rise gradually. And in patients with BPH, they appeared suddenly, and patient immediately must void. He cannot control this urge. And it may be complicated, but urge incontinence, and patient cannot reach toilet. He has no time. Frequency. No, frequent voiding, understandable. He can void every 2 hours, for example, and sometimes every 1 hour. And nocturia, frequent voiding at night. Diagnostic. Signs and symptoms. We will discuss in our classes special IPSS scale present. Physical examination, digital rectal examination, understandable, per rectum. Laboratory investigation. Sometimes when we must differentiate BPH and prostate cancer, it is lab investigation. Prostata-specific antigen, we investigate blood, and in normal it might be not more than 4 nanogram per liter. Ultrasonic sonography may be transabdominal or transrectal. X-ray examination, uroflowmetry is necessary, and cystoscopy. Well, such variant in this such picture when a doctor performs a digital rectal examination, knee elbow position. You can see this picture how we can palpate prostate gland per rectum. Differential diagnostic with the cancer. Cancer localized in the periphery parts of prostate. When we perform digital rectal examination, we must differentiate it. Some differences present. In this picture, doctor performs transrectal ultrasonic investigation. That, well, special probe, it is per rectum, it's inserting of this probe, and near prostate gland it localized, and we can perform investigation. Ultrasonic picture of prostate BPH, MRI picture of BPH, you can see enlarged prostate and urinary bladder. Rectum. Filling defect caused by prostate gland. And next, the therapy. We can perform conservative treatment in the last 30 to 40 years. We can use this medical treatment. Alpha blockers. What means alpha blockers? Neck of the urinary bladder and the prostatic part of the urethra have alpha 1 adrenal receptors. When they are irritated, spasm of thin muscles perform spasm and it's additional obstruction. They make additional obstruction. Compression of urethra by enlarged tumor on one hand and spasm of these muscles leads to additional compression of urethra. When we use alpha adrenal blockers, irritation of this alpha-adrenal receptor disappears and spasm of the smooth muscles disappears also and voiding improves. Next, 5 alpha reductase inhibitors, finasteride, also conservative treatment and combination of this treatment. Now you can see alpha blockers, action of alpha blockers. When we remove spasm improvement of voiding appears. Так, next. Surgical treatment, transurethral resection of the prostate glands. It is the gold standard of operative treatment. We can perform bicystoscope, resectoscope, the transurethral incision, transurethral electrovaporization, or open prostatectomy, suprapubic or retropubic. The same picture, that cystoscope, resectoscope, which performs resection. This loop, the special loops, it is for vaporization. You can see this zone of tissues which is resected. Different variants of loops. Now in this picture you can see step by step removes these tissues and after removing such picture. And next urethra forms from this cavity. Also picture of this transurethral resection, the when tissues removes by cystoscope, resectoscope. In this position performs this operation. Our lecture is over, and in our classes we will discuss it maybe more in detail. Thank you. Goodbye.
Спасибо.